Soundcheck. Gut. Yeah, looks like the war is over. This short engagement. And 14 boats were lost and 1,400 submariners. And we will deploy for Mid-Atlantic for a routine patrol in order to monitor commercial shipping. But could be, of course, that it's something will happen. Perhaps there's a submarine that didn't receive information. Let's say it was four tiger fish, four harpoons. In a Turkish submarine this time.
Control acoustics. New contact. Bearing 146. Designated Sierra 1.
Yeah, we don't need to monitor to track. Drop it. Yeah, let's get to COMSTEF. See what is going on the
Go
surface.
to depth 0, 1, 7 meters. Depth control I.
There's something else there. A Charlie.
Control acoustics. New contact. Bearing 1, 4, 5. Designated Sierra 2.
Is it also here? No. Okay. Sierra 2. It looks like this. Better get ready. Not sure if I want to get on periscope depth right now. But perhaps we will get some information about this Charlie. I will classify it as a threat until I know more, and we might already get some torpedoes ready for snapshots. You never know. War is over, but okay, tube 1 to 4 is loaded as torpedoes. Let's assign tube 1 and 2. Let's keep snapshot. Bearing is 145. Make sure that floor limit is big. And where was the layer? 300 meters. Let's keep one torpedo below the layer. In case it goes deep. Okay. Looks like it's quite fast. That would be not good. Slow down to 3.
Set revolutions for 3 knots. Propulsion I.
Charlie is what? I mean, is it really? Could it be? It could be anything, right? Charlie is just a guesstimate. But let's say it's TPK 7. Knots? I don't think so. Perhaps it is really coming that fast. But if it would be running 20 knots, it would be way louder. But it could be that it's below the layer. Yeah, with 3 knots we are not making it fast.
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion I.
I mean, that would make sense if it is that far away. But currently I have no business with them. We have a ceasefire in effect. Okay, 70 meters. Surface clear.
Extend the electronics mast. Senior watch, aye. Extend the radio antenna. Senior watch, aye.
Go to depth 0, 1, 6 meters. Depth control, aye.
Nothing.
Retract the electronics mast. Senior watch, aye. Retract the antenna. Senior watch, aye.
Go to depth 2, 4, 3 meters. Depth control, aye.
Damn it, I shouldn't have looked at this. But, I mean, we have a ceasefire in effect, right?
0, 1, 7 meters. Depth control, I.
Normally, I wouldn't kill submarines if there's a ceasefire. Just to make sure that we really picked up radio message, that the wire was not too added.
Set revolutions for 3 knots. Propulsion.
Radio antenna was not below the water or whatever. Let's make sure that we pick up whatever they. No, nothing. Good, let's track it then. Let's see what it is up to.
To depth 2, 4, 3 meters. Depth control I.
Set revolutions for 7 knots. Propulsion I.
Control acoustics. New contact. Bearing 1, 4, 3. Designated Sierra 3.
Typhoon ist laut. If it is a typhoon, but yeah, I mean the mission brief, the mission status screen already told us that this might be one. How fast is he? 10... How much? 19 knots, and yeah, but I've received no orders, nothing.
Engines ahead full, steering eye.
Submarine, hello. Yeah, hello. Yeah, not sure. I mean, perhaps the mission is not really... But normally it would make sense, you know, if the piece is already since some days in effect. If they would tell me via radio, rogue typhoon reported in your area, which is not under control anymore, rebel typhoon, destroy it or whatever they're planning to launch ballistic missiles. But I guess because I saw the mission status screen, it seems like we need to do it even while we didn't receive any information. Yeah, the normal typhoon, I'm not exactly sure, but I think normally I can't know that it's a typhoon. So yeah. Let's get into a fire position. Then we can decide what we want to do. Courier heading basically blind. But otherwise I can't keep up with this guy. If there's another submarine somewhere, we might run blind into it. I was not aware that there was a realistic modern submarine sim. There is actually there are some, most of them made by the same developer. Sonalist Combat Simulations. Subcommand and Dangerous Waters. Okay, let's check if the layer changed. We can run. I don't know how deep those boats can go. I don't think they can reach 300 meters. I mean, we can try. Below the layer would feel way better. 300 meters. I mean, we can see when they will report crash death. Layer is at 280. Yeah, let's see if we can make it.
Go to depth 2, 5, 3 meters. Depth control I.
The genre is making a comeback. Yeah, I think as well. Yeah. I think in general simulations, more realistic simulations making a comeback.
Go to depth 2, 6, 3 meters. Depth control I.
Okay, let's go 270, we almost reached it.
Go to depth 2, 7, 3 meters. Depth control I.
Okay. 280, we could be already in the layer.
Go to depth 2, 8, 1 meters. Depth control I.
Looks like
Captain,
those...
Approaching maximum depth.
Okay, approaching but not exceeding. Okay, let's do it in 5 meters.
Go to depth 2, 8, 5 meters. Depth
those Turkish boats can take some. Let's some depth.
Go to depth 290 meters. Depth control I.
But I better save. But I think in subcommand you are also informed when you exceed, right? Approaching, and then there's another message coming, like in dangerous waters, exceeding.
Go to depth 295 meters. Depth control I.
Because your boat might explode suddenly.
Go to depth 300 meters. Depth control I. Captain, exceeding maximum depth.
Okay, stay 295.
Go to depth 295 meters. Depth control I.
Okay, that's good. Can we even run flank now? I think now we are below the layer. I mean, the typhoon could be also below the layer. I don't think so. Otherwise, yeah, we can't check it out because we're running too fast. But otherwise, I wouldn't have heard it. Let's go flank.
Engines ahead, flank, steering eye.
Okay, yeah, that's not really worth it. This one is not worth it. I mean, flank running is not really what you want to do on most boats.
Engines ahead full, steering eye.
Let's keep it full. 20 knots is fine. And he also, if he's that really that fast, and according to the demon, he is that fast. We can even hear him. Yeah, but he was 20 knots. Yeah, he's riding 20 knots indeed. And most Soviet boats most Russian boats have deep turns per knot 7. This is why I don't complain about Cold Waters. I think it did well enough that many gamers makers took notice. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think the same. It's not always this battle about. This is not whatever. The devs themselves stated that they are going for a mix of whatever. That they're going for Red Storm Rising. And Red Storm Rising also wasn't full realism. It was action-packed, similar to SSN. I think SSN, Tom Clancy's SSN, was also not full realism. It was semi-realistic, mixed with action. And also had this distance scaling. Where what you see is not the true distance. It seems they took inspiration from those two games, which were very popular games among many gamers. And I know a lot of people that play Dangerous Waters and started with Cold Waters, so it's absolutely fine. They might find interest in submarines. They might think, okay, interesting. I want to know more. I want to experience other games. So I think it's also always useless when those fanboy wars, I mean, most same people, if they find interest in a game which is a niche game. I think submarine simulations, especially modern submarine simulations, there is not much around. And then you find interest, you might check out other games. And yeah, so there's absolutely no need for fanboyism. It is a win-win situation for everybody. And Cold Waters definitely revived. I can see it on the Subsim forums. You see how many viewers are sitting in a forum or viewing it. And I think since Cold Waters, all numbers increased. Also in Dangerous Waters, the players increased again. The viewers, the activity increased. I can definitely tell. Also the same, I'm pretty sure Cold Waters also, for example, helped with sales for Dangerous Waters. Because way more reviews appeared there on Steam. It was now even by some other retailer, other online shop, they even remastered, not remastered it, but made it completely compatible for Windows 10 without this patch. Streamers checked, I didn't check out how much people stream, because I usually don't. I was thinking my game crashed, better save. Sound disappeared for a second. Yeah, and play both games, so if you enjoy one game more, period. it in other games too. Yeah. And yeah, you see there's many games coming up in this Fleet Command style. Sure, if there's a lot of competition in one genre, then I think especially for multiplayer games it can hurt if there's a lot of competition. Not hurt, but for example, what I think is somewhat noticeable is World War II hardcore shooters. But I don't know exactly, perhaps it's also the same effect. But there, you know, there's Hell Let Loose, there's Postscriptum, there is Project Reality, World War II. Now, no, that is a World War I game that was released now. And another game. But on the other hand, it helps always to get more people. And I see a general trend that people are more interested into complex games, not always this arcade, simplified games. And, you know, sometimes the market dictates interest. I think there was never absolute no interest in those games. It's simply nobody did them. There was no, you know, sometimes the market is dictating interests. If the market is supplementing you with simplified games, people will buy simplified games. And but yeah, great to have. So it looks like the market is now very saturated, especially in those standard games, those, I don't know, sandbox shooter, open world shooters, or open world games, or this and that, arcade shooters, arcade this and that, very saturated. So I guess people return again into those sim areas, have success with it. Others see, oh, hey, look, you can do a realistic game without somebody coming over and say, that's too difficult. Sure, there are people like this, but there are enough who look exactly for it. I mean, modern submarine simulation. Yeah, or modern surface fleet simulation. There's nothing around. Nothing. And there's a lot of people that would like to get into it. It would be good to hear squishing sounds. What do you mean? It makes sense to me. The PC games market has exploded with the advent of streaming, and the new market is growing older, getting into more complex and major titles. Yeah, I think also, I hope that. I mean, the AAA stuff is, or the really big, but who cares? Those multi-million projects, they are still very traditional, but that's okay. But yeah, those, I think there are some times returning, like we had, I mean, we didn't play those most games back in the days. Was too young and had other stuff on the mind, but stuff like Falcon. In the 90s, there were a lot of complex games, even with story elements. Really good ideas that got dropped. Man, this guy is so, I'm now basically in a lag pursuit. Not in a lag pursuit, I can close in a bit, but after that, we are basically in same speed. Yeah, I can make one nut. We need to get a nut. I mean, he's also running blind, so let's get him. 21 knots. Propulsion I. We are almost at 6 miles, and then I can catch him. He might even not hear the torpedo. If I fire the torpedo, he might. If he's running 20 knots constant. Oh shit! We lost him 2 hours ago. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah, I should of course check sometimes. This piece is so wrong.
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion I.
He made a. He already is away. Yeah, absolutely. Come on. Don't tell me he's. Ah, shit, I need to go get above the layer.
Go to depth 195.
If he made a. Oh, he's. Yeah, he's here. He's here. He's exactly here. Perfect. Get below the layer. What was it? What was Crush Dev? forgot it.
Go to depth 280 meters. Depth control I.
Okay, great. He didn't change anything.
Engines ahead, flank, steering I.
Man, this guy going crazy on us. Okay. You are working hard for lesser money, very niche market. That is why DCS World DLCs have astronomic prices. I think 20 years PC gaming will be dominated by simulation games of all type and will use DLC similar to how DCS or Command does it. Yeah, I also think it will be, there will be more around. People will explore simulation games again, like in the 90s, where you had tank simulations, this simulations. You see, there's already this, I mean, most of those games you can't take serious,
Captain,
you know.
Approaching maximum depth.
Thief simulator, you know, this rather ironic simulation genre. But it tells also that people like to explore stuff that people fought for. Would make sense, like, I don't know, train simulations are a real thing and even have a market. But so, like, I don't know, cleaning houses or whatever, and stuff like this is around. Yeah, military simulations, you see there's a lot of coming up. Sea Power, yeah, Command boomed, DCS boomed, DCS is the best example, look at those guys, how they boomed. And they kept it full hardcore. They didn't go maybe and said, yeah, we need to do it, otherwise nobody buys it. They kept it full hardcore. Every button is clickable. Yeah. Beforehand, they had lock-on. Lock-on was a rather semi-realistic approach. I mean, it modeled everything realistic, but without this hitting all switches and everything, and without those super avionics. And they started with Black Shark to go full hardcore. And it's even too hardcore for me, Black Shark, when this helicopter is so complicated. But look at now, they have a lot of success. Yeah, those Russian developers, some of those Russian developers, they really kept the bastion of simulation games. A lot of those more hardcore simulation games, tank simulations, flight simulations came from Russia. It looks like in Russia there is a big community for simulation games, military-wise. Yeah, that's and because the astronomic prices. Yeah, I mean, let's in the end, if you plan to spend with something, I don't know. Look at on the other side, you know, there's a Call of Duty. I bought Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Just for the main campaign, multiplayer absolutely not interesting for me. I paid $60 and played the campaign in 6 hours. Yeah. And games like, I don't know, Combat Mission or DCS, yes, they are expensive and some stuff. But if you know, they also make sales, and I think if you're not completely stupid, even if money is a concern, you might find some chances. Same with Matrix games, yeah. Command or War in the Pacific, they are also very expensive, but I mean, there's always an opportunity to get those games for a bit less. You need simply to wait for the, and for example, Christmas is coming up, yeah. I also got Command, original Command on a sale, and I got TechView on a sale and everything, and DCS also sometimes makes 50% sales. You don't need to get it in early access, man. Why? If you, yeah, sure. If you want to have it immediately, the F-14 or whatever, well then. But I think as a grown-up, you can also wait some time and do some other business. There's so millions of games. There's even millions of free games around or simulations. I rather have the problem that I not have enough time. And even I think with $0 you can get so many games. And yeah. Or mods. JRPG, Pixel Indie. Shits. If Danger is what was sold today, it would be $100 title. Yeah, I would buy it. If Sonalis would return, but currently it looks like they are too busy with their military contracts. Because those guys, we knew how to... I mean, I played Fleet Command some days ago. It's quite crazy how good this game was from the mechanics, even after all those years. Okay, yeah. Imagine that's how collisions happen. One submarine is hunting the other one while being absolutely blind. I mean, we are not completely blind. I have my high frequency, but we need to watch out that we don't run into the typhoon. Yeah, better safe. But yeah, this guy is really fast. I'm pushing here my Turkish submarine to the max. But soon we can fire. I think at 6 miles we can indeed fire. I mean, I didn't receive any orders. I guess this mission is a bit sloppy, but okay. Let's fire. Or did somebody ask me to copy broadcast? And this guy won't hear it. Okay, he classified as an Oscar II. Yeah, Oscars are similar to Typhoons. I think it's a Typhoon because I already got spoiled. Oh shit, did he slow down? Why is he speed 10 knots? Nah, come on, that's not possible. Better slow down. He bypassed it and he will fire a torpedo from behind. Okay.
Set revolutions for 5 knots, propulsion I.
Yeah, I think for our last mission, there could be something more, a bit more sophisticated, but okay. Okay, let's wait for the sonars to come back online. It is a typhoon. It is a typhoon ballist. Oh, is he really that far away?
Set revolutions for 21 knots. Propulsion I.
Did he slow down? Nah, it's not possible, otherwise he would be closer. Need to watch really for a high frequency. Let's get into the high frequency before I crash into him. But I think also it works good. I mean, there are different philosophies. You see, Comet Mission also now starts somewhat to drop its high price mentality or high price philosophy. With Matrix, they will now at least participate in sales. With Shock Force, I guess it is a field experiment. It is not obligated. There are also war games that are sold for normal price. So, yeah. It depends, of course. I guess you need to do some. They do some simple calculations, see what happens, how much they sell with this price or whatever, how much they sell with this price. The problem is, of course, that there's not much room. If you go down with the price once, there's no way to go back. But yeah, with sales, I think games like Command, there's always a way to acquire them. Even if you're low on money, or if it hurts too much. I think those people that are complaining often that something is too expensive, too hard to get, Those guys are the guys that buy Call of Duty Day One every year, or FIFA. So yeah, it's sometimes funny. I'm pretty sure that's those people that complain first about prices, often. I mean, what is true is that somebody said that video games have comparably low prices compared to other entertainment products. I also don't want to have prices increased, but it is not completely untrue. If you take a look, if you go into a cinema, yeah, you might end up with 15-20 bucks for watching a 2-hour movie. And if you if you compare it to other entertainment stuff. Yes, on the other hand, streaming services are quite cheap again. Yeah, it depends. That's also why they always try to sell those VIP editions, ultimate editions, because those suits are, you know, number one priority for them was many years, they were absolutely keen on rising prices for video games. Those big developers like Blizzard, Activision, EA, they felt not that the prices were not justified, but they knew that they couldn't rise it by simply doing it. That's always why they tried with those day one DLCs and premium editions and whatever VIP editions to establish a new standard. Interesting is that exactly the opposite developed, that even lower prices are now somewhat more attractive, which I guess started with those indie games, then other games followed. If Sonalists would sell a Dangerous Waters Remastered Edition upgrade to DirectX or something, they could sell it for 100 and use your money to fund Dangerous Waters 2, I would buy it. Yeah, it's the same, yeah. And first change the title, I don't know, Dangerous Waters. It's, for me, it sounds like some shark movie. I wonder, because many people know Subcommand, but I mean, not those guys that are in this area that play, that like to play Sims, but in general, a lot of people know Subcommand. I think it has something to do with the naming. Subcommand, Fleet Command, Dangerous Waters. Dangerous Waters could be also some teenager drama or some guys, I don't know, some coming of age movie about some guys going to some Caribbean island, having fun there, and then some super shark appears, eating everybody. Dangerous Waters, the movie. I think there's a reason why many war games have generic names. Because it might be indeed helping if the title immediately suggests what is going on. Okay. Slow down.
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion I.
50 minutes old. He could be everywhere. Where is he? Oh shit, is he gone? No way. No, here he is. Okay. Yeah, update. I have to say, auto crew. Wake up. How the heck is he doing that? He's running faster than 20 knots. I can't get, he's teleporting when this is Captain Ramius, I can't get to him. Now wait, I think the data is sketchy. Simply, let's fire a torpedo in the direction. Yeah, I will do it. I will fire a torpedo simply in his direction. I don't care anymore. This guy is, I don't know, he's on autopilot. He's on flight mode, iPhone. We will snapshot towards TOF 242. I think he will not hear the torpedo. He's heading for the US. That's Harpoon's right there. Yeah. I don't think that he's so far away. We simply have not enough data to establish distance. Yeah, floor go maximum and write the torpedo below the layer, at exactly at my depth. Speed 40. Snapshot bearing is 234. Fire. Which torpedo tube is it? Tube 1.
Launch tube 1. Yes, Captain.
I don't care anymore. This guy must be somewhere in front of us. Yeah, I think that would be a good plan. $60 game plus $100 submarine pass. Okay, there is a torpedo going. That is my torpedo right here on the high end. Yeah. And I don't know, do I want to speed up behind the torpedo? I think so.
Set revolutions for 21 knots.
And we could also do an active intercept, but if he uses active sonar, he immediately knows that I'm behind him. I think right now. Oh, slow down. What is happening? Is he coming at us?
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion
did 9. Nah. Are you sure that he's coming towards us? Did he hear something? But he might not hear the torpedo. Nah, come on, he's not that fast. Get the data right. Show me TMA. Yeah, TMA won't tell you anything because we're exactly behind him. Nah, CR2. It could be every direction, it's absolutely useless. We need to increase, yeah, this makes more sense. But I don't think he's that far away, he's somewhere here. Okay, that's right behind it, but I might die, but I don't know anything to do. I mean, otherwise we need to hunt him down for days. But he might hear the active intercept, that is a problem. I should have done the torpedo passive. Ah, damn it, I can launch a second one. Yeah, a passive torpedo against submarines is always bad. What is the maximum speed of a Typhoon? Passive torpedoes, but if he's running 20 knots, he might even really not hear it, even active. Activate it and see what will happen. Why is he snaking? Now the tiger fish are they snaking? Ah, damn it. Did he find something? Yes, the last mission. You need a fast boat for the last mission. You need some nuclear attack boat. But perhaps it will help to get. Perhaps the Typhoon will evade.
Control acoustics. Tube 1 wire has been cut.
Okay.
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion.
See where he is. How old is this data? 0 minutes. How the heck is he. can't get this guy. Is this some Turkish reserve, Turkish turbo nitro?
Set revolutions for 21 knots. No. Propulsion I.
I can't get this boat faster. We are running.
Engines
flank.
Ahead, flank steering. Engines ahead, flank 22. Steering.
22. What is the speed of a Typhoon? I think he's running faster than 20. Speed 12 knots. 25 submerged. We can't get this guy. He is outrunning us. Persevering. I don't know what to do. I have no sub rocks. I have but the harpoons also don't work. I should have engaged him in the beginning. There was a window, but now it seems like it is closed. Those Tigerfish torpedoes, they are not having a good range. They have a proper range, but they're too slow. I can't get this guy. He's... But we can try our best. But $120 once for a sim and a couple DLC packs is too expensive. Which game do you mean? Yeah, I think DCS can really become expensive. I was thinking about playing this campaign. There's a campaign for FR18 which has some good story, or seems to have some story, and was made with some real pilots, because I think often the campaigns in DCS are rather lacking. Campaign design is often really boring. I only play those custom campaigns made by users or whatever, and $10 is okay for them. But then you need this island, you need this island. I mean, for people that play a lot of multiplayer, this is good, but if you only want to play it for a campaign, I think this is really hardcore. You need to get FR18, you need to get Super Carrier, you need to get Persian Gulf, and yeah, I think that's it, right? So anything else? And the campaign. And then you can play the campaign. Oh man. Gazelle Kadim. Wait. Stop. Gazelle Kadim. You know what would be funny? If this guy would stop, turn 180, wait for me, while I blind run into him. I better save. If this crashed, it would be absolutely... I mean, he could... perhaps... normally, he should hear the torpedo. I mean, if it was active intercepting, even if you active intercepting from behind, it looks like this guy is absolutely not caring. I mean, if he's running really fast, and the torpedo was below the layer, he might not heard the active intercepting, but I don't know. Normally you hear it. Should move so the top noise isn't fooling the contact. Yeah, this contact is anyways. If you're exactly behind a target, it is absolutely... But I know that he's indeed on this distance because he might be even far away. Because the beam rate is so slow, if this is for TMA, the worst situation. If you're exactly behind the target, you can tell nothing about the contact. But you can assume that he's really running fast, otherwise I would already drive into him. But we are almost not close. Oh, here! Is it a torpedo? We found him! Oh shit, he's really close. Slow down. Get torpedoes ready.
Revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion I.
He's on a high frequency, that means he's close. Okay, one above the layer, one below the layer. Let's do it like this. 300, I think deeper those boats can't go, but ceiling floor is enabled to 500. Good. Give me active intercept mark. I don't care for TMA.
Control acoustics. New contact. Bearing 2.
Active intercept mark. Fire. 2 torpedoes. Tube 1, tube 2, fire. If you flood them, you can't use the quick fire anymore. That's strange. Okay, then do it manually. Are we too deep? What the heck is going on? Ah, man, somebody upgraded to master. That's the problem, okay. No, we can fire. Yeah, that is. If you upgrade a contact to master, it is removed from. Yeah, I think he won't hear it. It's fire.
Launch tube one. Control acoustics. Torpedo is running normal. Launch tube two. Control acoustics. Torpedo is running normal.
Set revolutions for 15 knots. Propulsion high.
Active intercept. Yeah, okay, we turned away. I don't see him anymore, but I mean, he is there. What was it? 1-2 nautical miles. Yeah, okay, makes sense. I think he was even closer. Where's the mark? The mark is here. Both are quiet. We'll put one torpedo in the reserve. There's no need to come in from the same angle. We will ride one torpedo to the flank in case he manages somehow to dupe them. But he's here somewhere. I think now we got him. I mean, there's subsway. I think he still didn't realize what is going on. He hears nothing. He's riding in a bubble of in a warp bubble. I mean, if you push a typhoon through 25 knots, I don't want to know what you leave for. The half of the ocean is moving. It looks like some typhoon. Okay, look.
Set revolutions for 5 knots. Propulsion I.
Did he avoid the torpedo? No, that's not possible, right? But he's not locking on it. But yeah, it could wait. The angle is still okay. This is not true contact. Oh, is he that fast? Those torpedoes are too slow. Yeah, I need to follow him, otherwise we end up again.
Contact. Bearing. 3, 1, 2.
Designated Sierra. That's not possible. 5. Must be... What's this passive sonar? What? Who's this guy? Nah, you can't tell me. That is... How is it possible? He must be somewhere here. Otherwise I will cheat. Give me active high frequency. Nah, he is... The torpedoes must tracking him. Don't tell me stuff. How did he... That's not possible, did he? Yeah, the torpedo is doing something. You see both torpedoes. Yeah. We got him. Finally. God damn it, that is. Okay, I don't know what's going on with this torpedo, but he is. Let's shut him down before he kills.
Control acoustics. Torpedo 2. Ah, finally. Has turned off.
We got it. We got it.
Set revolutions for
need alpha. Yeah, with an alpha, that would be light speed. That would be like intercepting with I don't know what. With a, alpha. What? 46? With alpha, you can basically simply go into a carrier group. Okay, let's go up to Comstev.
Go to depth 0, 1, 7 meters.
Master 1 is no more. That's absolutely unbelievable how big they built those subs. You need to see a comparison. Compare this Turkish submarine with the size of this thing. There's some those silhouettes, those 2D silhouettes. Okay, let's get up. That was the campaign. War is over, but unfortunately we had for some reason to kill this. I guess this guy was heading for the west coast. Some rogue submarine.
Surface the ship. Yes, dear Captain. Initiating normal release of air from all main ballast tanks. Extend the radio antenna. Senior watch, aye. Extend the electronics mast. Senior watch, aye. Extend the radar mast. Senior watch, aye.
Control station, new radio message received.
Ah, now the message appeared. Flash, flash, flash. Emergency task during US Army intelligence sweeps of Russian Naval Command sent sequences to launch an SLBM strike against the United States in the event that Russia lost the conventional war. Ooh, yeah, okay. Plan called for two Typhoon SSBNs, one from Northern Fleet and one from Red Banner. Oh oh. Two Typhoons confirmed unaccounted. What, there's a second? Yeah, you need to play this with an alpha. You need to play this with an alpha. Because I guess you received a message quite late and then you need to search for it, but with a Turkish submarine it would be too... But who is this guy? Is this... Could it be that this is the second Typhoon? Nah, I don't think so. No. But is there a second Typhoon? No. Yeah, mission accomplished. We can tell the US we even without orders we saved the US without even knowing that it is hostile. We simply assumed it. Shoot and ask questions later. Yeah, those missions are designed normally for faster boats, these campaign missions. For nuclear attack boats. But we also managed it. Took some time, but we managed it to prevent this plan to come to fruition. ...1,200 meters. What is the depth? 4,000 meters. Oh man, this thing will never be found again. Okay, that's it. That was the Atlantic Freeze campaign. I think I will do another round, but I need first to figure out what I will play. Either Dangerous Waters or Subcommand. Perhaps I will continue the Cold War campaign, that looked really good. With the 688. I will try out another boat. Okay. What? Incomplete, why? I killed it too fast. Yeah, I guess it, whatever, but it's okay. We did it. Not sure why it didn't trigger. Ja, got some new missions. Oh my god, there are so many sub-command campaigns. Operation Icarus Northern Fleet with the Akula. What is Operation Icarus? Training exercise. Perhaps this short campaign. I like campaigns. Albany, that is also focusing on a 688. You guessed it, the Albany. Turk Terror. Destroy Turkish surface elements. No. I was thinking we can play the Turkish. What is this? Hostile Waters. That would be perhaps a name. Hostile Waters for Dangerous Waters. I think it's even better than Dangerous Waters. K-219. What is K-219 for a boat? Okay, yeah, Albany. That is interesting. Atlantic freeze completed. Danger Hour. Track a new Russian SSB based on James Francis' book Danger Hour. Yeah, that sounds good. Tuxen. I always like when something is based on a book. Cooler campaign. Another campaign. Falkland campaign, Diamonds campaign, Sakhalin Saw campaign. Oh, that is really like I think I never will finish it. Yeah, exactly. This campaign I can't press because I didn't modify the file. Yeah, okay. I will check it out. Perhaps I will play something short. I want to test out some boats from nations to complete the nations. Showcase all nations that start in Eramot and in SCX subcommand. See you in 5 minutes or so.